Hey there, and welcome back to another Fantastic Beasts video. And a while ago, we saw the first look trailer for the third installment of the Fantastic Beasts franchise, Fantastic Beasts and the Secrets of Dumbledore. And you can see my breakdown of that here. And I'll be honest with you, I was not overly impressed by what I saw in that first trailer. It's not that it looked bad per se, just I don't think it had anything that really stood out and gripped me like I hoped it would. And so when the latest trailer released earlier today, I was hopeful that this would change. And hell yeah, it did. This was leagues better than the first trailer, and it's made me feel a whole lot better about the direction of the story, but also about the whole design of the world and the way in which magic's portrayed. It felt more diverse and vibrant and exciting, whilst also having a really interesting looking plot. But anyway though, with all that being said, let's take an actual look at the trailer, skipping over any repeat scenes from the previous trailer, unless I have anything new to say about them from last time. And they open the trailer with another old archive footage shot from the Harry Potter films of Dumbledore looking into the Pensieve, whilst his quote from the Half-Blood Prince, I think, where he tells Harry why he needs Slughorn's memory, plays over the top. And honestly, whilst it doesn't have any direct relevance to this film except to set up that we'll probably be delving into Dumbledore's memories, I actually think putting this here was a good choice for the trailer. I think it's pretty safe to say at this point that Crimes of Grindelwald did not do as well as it was supposed to do. And then further controversies have since dragged the franchise through the mud, so to speak. So showing Michael Gambon, and having that quote from the original series, it just harkens back to those earlier films and plays on the audience's sense of nostalgia to get them more invested. And honestly, it's a pretty smart strategy, and it kind of worked on me at least. We then move on to see that Gryffindor chasing the snitch clip again around Hogwarts. And I didn't really notice this at first in the first trailer, but does that clip look not quite right to anybody else? Like, I don't know, the dude on the broom, he doesn't seem real. The CGI is not that great, unlike the rest of the trailer. It looks like one of those clips that they play on interactive roller coaster rides that look good enough for that sort of thing, but you can tell they didn't have the same budget. It's just a small thing, but once I saw it, I couldn't unsee it. Also, just a side note, surely there would have been more people just walking around the grounds. It just felt too empty. Anyway, we then get a transitional scene where I think McGonagall comes to give Dumbledore news about Grindelwald at the Hog's Head. And of all the things in this movie, one of the things I'm most hyped about is seeing the interactions between the Dumbledore brothers. In the books, well, it's made pretty clear that there is little love lost between them. Aberforth is clearly deeply bitter towards his brother. And Albus honestly seems a bit mocking of Aberforth in turn. But then it's also made clear that Albus would regularly go to the Hog's Head to drink. So do they just sit there in silence and glare at each other? Does Albus just prattle on about anything and everything to Aberforth while he tries to ignore him? It's honestly just an intriguing prospect to actually see them interact properly, for the first time. But from here, the trailer moves on to Grindelwald. And honestly, at first, I didn't know what to think about Grindelwald. I wasn't a hardcore Johnny Depp man, but Jesus, this version looks and acts really differently, doesn't he? And I'm still not 100% sure if I like it. I don't know, this version definitely feels like a wait and see sort of thing. On one hand, I wasn't that fussed with Depp's performance. I'd grown accustomed to it, but I wasn't fussed about it. And then on the other hand, Mikkelsen is a tremendous actor. So yeah, this is definitely a wait and see moment. It could be a terrible change, or it could be the best one of all time. And then we get a few repeat scenes that we saw in the previous trailer. Grindelwald holding his rally in, I'm gonna go out on a limb and say, Bhutan, and then wiping Yusuf's memory, and then we get another look at the battle between Credence and Albus that was set up in the first trailer. And I gotta say, that fight is looking like it's gonna be cool. I think one of the worst parts of the franchise as a whole is when they just default to a lame, clear-coloured spell firing off followed by a Avada Kedavra versus generic red spell in a big power beam. I mean, visually, the best fight of all time is Dumbledore versus Voldemort at the Ministry. And I'm so glad to see elements of that sort of thing returning, using different spells and environmental attacks, like ripping off the roof of a building and launching the rubble. It just makes the action seem more intense, and makes the characters, who are supposed to be high-level wizards, seem like really big deals. We then see Kowalski essentially getting drafted into helping the wizards by a new character who I think is supposed to be Professor at Ilvermorny. And yeah, this scene actually did give me a brief chuckle. I do love jokes like this, and Jacob's scenes, whilst maybe a little bit cringy sometimes, always strike that nice balance between comic relief and drama. And also, did she steal a pastry from his shop? That's harsh. And then they double down on the Jacob gets a wand scene. And the more they show it, the more they advertise it, the more I think it's going to be some sort of fake out, and this is not a real magical wand. Otherwise, they're going to need to explain how this works. How could he slip through the cracks? And do you want some trash tinfoil that is obviously not true? Disclaimer ahead. What if Jacob is secretly Corvus Lestrange? After all, he has dark hair. He could have been lied to about his origin. They're giving him a curvy sort of wand. Bellatrix had a curvy sort of wand, didn't she? And I know she's not a Lestrange by birth, but the connection is still there. Plus, baby Corvus supposedly drowned on his way to America. But he might not have. After all, wouldn't Yusuf have felt his magical oath just stop working if the kid was dead? Because the vow is technically fulfilled. Kid's dead. It indicates that he could feel something was off, right? Perhaps this baby was saved and taken in by a nice Polish immigrant family. I mean, adoption back then was often just not talked about as much. People could go their whole lives not knowing. I mean, that even happens today.
Coincidence? I think not!
And then you can just explain away him looking so old and rough by being poor and living through the war. And look, I know this is a stupid crack theory, but the wiki says that they do have a similar birth year, so who knows? But seriously, it's not true. It would just be so stupid. But if it is right, I'm taking credit all the same. More realistically, it's just a pretend wand that's enchanted to do a couple of spells just by waving it around, like a toy wand, basically. And I think that's kind of backed up by that last scene of the trailer where Dumbledore asks if he's enjoying the wand, and Jacob asks if he could keep it. If he was actually a wizard, surely he'd just be allowed to have the wand. And then the next scene of note is Grindelwald and the gang turning up in fancy clothes at what I think would be the banquet from the first trailer. And here, Yusuf is standing with the other people who were all shown to be sympathisers. So I'm wondering if maybe he does betray them all in the end. I thought Imperius Curse at first, but now I'm less certain. And then we get a shot of Aberforth looking at a mirror with writing appearing. And now the first words are, "Do you know?" But the bottom is not really easy to make out and it has letters missing. So either they've edited the shot for a tasty reveal in the cinema, which they often do in trailers, or more writing's going to appear as the scene progresses. Either way, I'm no code breaker, so I'm not even going to attempt this. You can have a crack if you want. And another thing of note from this trailer, Grindelwald seems to have gained insane popularity. Seriously, it's like he's a freaking god, and he just looks so smug. Maybe I am coming around to this portrayal after all. This guy, I can understand people looking at and thinking, ooh, he does seem like a good choice to lead us. Johnny Depp's version looked like a serial killer. Who would follow him? Also, I love that we get to see a scene of Albus and Grindelwald sitting down at a cafe having a chat. You can just tell that scene's going to be intense and important. And there's going to be a lot of interesting things revealed in that conversation. Also, I found it interesting that they state that it was Dumbledore that came up with the idea to reshape society in the first place. I always kind of figured it was Grindelwald sort of poking and prodding and leading him by the nose and manipulating him. But here it kind of suggests that Dumbledore actually crafted the ideology and then let this psycho have it. He's the brains behind it. And I kind of like that, and I think it adds a lot of depth to both their characters and makes it all a lot more of a grey area. And then after that, we get a bit of a fast-paced montage. I gotta say, this montage, this was it. I loved it. Dumbledore fighting Credence, yes. And also not looking all that merciful, so intense Albus, I'm all here for it. Then Newt versus Credence and the terrorists, Theseus and the professor beating down some other terrorists, some poor bastard getting murdered by, what, a giant scorpion thing? Ugh, bad luck, mate. New beasts, Grindelwald versus Dumbledore, aggressive books, the phoenix? Ugh, so awesome. I feel like a kid again. And the best part, the fights are actually diverse and different, not spamming the same spells, using environmental hazards like crystal balls or water, phasing through walls, just different colours for once. This is what I'm talking about. This is everything the second film should have been. I'm actually super hyped for this now. And that's really all I have to say about the trailer. I'm hyped, and this looks like a big improvement on the second one. So hopefully they don't let me down. But anyway, with all that being said, these were just my opinions, and now I'd like to hear yours. What do you think of the trailer? Looks good, looks bad? I'm curious for your thoughts, so make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and let me know.